All right, so continue our discussion on angle proofs. We've got number four up here. So we are show that if ray ZX bisects angle WZY, then the measure of angle one is equal to 1/2 times the measure of angle WZY. Okay, so we're given our statements. We need to fill in our reasons. Okay, so statement A states that ray ZX bisects angle WZY. That is our given statement. So that's how we got the first one. So now we have statement B. Measure of angle one is equal to measure of angle two. So over in our illustration, we have angle one and angle two, and they both make up WZY. So how do we know that they're equal to each other? Well, if we look back up at statement A, we see the term bisects. And remember, a bisector, whether it's with segments or with angles, a bisector in general is something that cuts another thing into two equal parts. So for this ray right here to bisect this angle, that would then tell me that angle one is equal to angle two. So I know that statement B, measure of angle one is equal to measure of angle two, by the definition of an angle bisector. That's just a straight up definition. Okay. Now statement C, the measure of angle WZY is equal to the measure of angle one plus the measure of angle two. Okay. So again, this is going to be using angle addition postulate. So WZY is my big angle. One and two are my two smaller angles. So the measure of these two small angles will equal the measure of my big angle. So that's using the angle addition postulate. So normally we would see how these are kind of feeding off each other, but really these three are kind of helping us to set up the rest of our proof. So let's keep moving. So statement D says the measure of angle WZY is equal to the measure of angle one plus the measure of angle one. So if we look back at statement B, measure of angle one is equal to measure of angle two. So we know those are equal to each other because they're the definition of an angle bisector. So now from C to D, the only thing that changes is this measure of angle two becomes measure of angle one. So we know that we can substitute in measure of angle one for measure of angle two because of statement B. So to get from C to D, I had to use substitution property. So statement E states that the measure of angle WZY is equal to two times the measure of angle one. Okay, so keep in mind that if I have x plus x and I add those together, I'm gonna get 2x. So that's gonna be the same thing of what's happening right here. I've got one measure of angle one plus another measure of angle one. So when I add those together, I will get two measure of angle ones or two times the measure of angle one. Okay, so don't get too confused about this terminology of measure of angle one. Just pretend like it's just any other variable. Just say x plus x, and we see that you're more easily able to see that it is two times x. So to get from D to E, I had to combine like terms. Okay, so now to get from E to F. Okay, so I see now 1/2 times the measure of WZY is equal to measure of angle one. So I need to divide both sides by two to get rid of that thing. So that was using the division property. And now to go from F to G. Statement G states that the measure of angle 1 is equal to 1/2 times the measure of angle WZY. So recall the symmetric property. Symmetric property states that if A equals B, then B equals A. So basically, I can flip these things to put them on the other side of the equal sign because that's exactly how I wanted it to be worded, was the measure of angle 1 is equal to 1/2 times the measure of angle WZY. So to get from statement F to G, I had to use the symmetric property.